Hello everyone, Michelle here with Tony from Plant Based on a Budget.
Hi.
And Rachel from The Plant Riot. Yeah. And we're here at Sprouts. And we're going to show you some of the coolest fall-themed, Thanksgiving-themed, holiday-themed vegan products that we can find here today. So we're going to do a little haul. Yay! Yeah. All right, guys, we are back home with our haul from Sprouts of Thanksgiving slash holiday-themed goodies that are totally plant-based and vegan. Mm-hmm. So we're going to go one by one and show you some of the exciting things that we found. They had a ton.
Like, yeah, it was so much awesome stuff at the moment. It's great.
Hard to choose.
I know.
It was really hard. Tony, do you want to start?
Yes. Okay. Hi everyone, by the way. This is my new backyard.
Woo! I love it.
Okay, so I am going with Dandies.
We love Dandies.
They make vegan marshmallows and it is the first time I've ever had one. I actually want to try it with you guys right now, so I'm going to break it open.
Oh, yum, yeah.
And we're going to...
I was hoping you'd do that.
Oh, and then they also have a pumpkin.
Oh, yeah. So we got these.
Mmm. Minty.
Whoa. Mmm. And like a mocha to make like a peppermint
so
mocha.
So good in a like, hot chocolate.
And what I want to do is I want to make a Rice Krispie treat using these marshmallows so that it's special for... the holiday season.
And you could take like candy canes and crush them up on top and make them delicious.
And if you're confused about why marshmallows are not vegan, it's because they usually contain gelatin. So if you were thinking about making Rice Krispie treats, I highly recommend looking for Dandies because they are the best.
Yep, and gelatin, for those who don't know, is not even vegetarian. It's made from like animal skin and bones. It's been boiled, like totally nasty. So Dandies and also Trader Joe's has vegan marshmallows now.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I will go next. I'm gonna do a classic that I've featured many times before. This is the field roast, basically turkey. They have a field roast, which is just their normal one. And this is their fancy en croûte that's basically layered in, what do you call that? Filo dough, pastry dough?
Mm-hmm.
Pastry dough, and it's stuffed with cranberries and hazelnut goodness. So this thing is kind of expensive. It was like $25.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, that's
expensive. Yeah, but if you're gonna buy a turkey and put it on the table, that's expensive.
And I was looking at the prices of the other one and that was actually cheaper, like turkey was $27.99.
Oh, really? Yeah.
And that
there was one that was like $16 or $14. So they have different prices. They had so many options. I'll insert a little clip. So here at Sprouts, there's a whole section for a lot of their plant-based options. We've got tofurkey, we've got dark gardenes, stuffed turkey, there's the full one, and my personal favorite, field roast holiday en croûte. Mmm, so good. Oh, also, I haven't even tried this one before. Worthington makes vegan dinner roasts as well. And down here they have vegan cheesecakes. So much to choose from when you're planning a plant-based Thanksgiving. Sprouts is a really great place to go if you're looking for a centerpiece that you don't want to have to make by hand from scratch.
Yeah, and I know Trader Joe's has one similar to this, and I think it's like $12 or $13.
Yep.
I tried it last week and it's really, really tasty.
Awesome. Yeah. Okay.
All right, so my special treat for the holidays is this Clif Bar. So at this time of the year, they have all these different flavors. So mine, the one I chose to show you guys today is this spiced pumpkin bar.
I've not tried that one
yet. Oh, it's really yummy. It's very pumpkin-y. This time of the year, they have the gingerbread one as well.
Oh, yeah,
which
that one's
really
good.
Tasty.
I haven't had that one.
So yeah,
really
so good. Pumpkin spice and gingerbread. These are the Clif Bars that I like to get at this time of the year.
And they're all vegan.
The Clif Bars are all vegan as far as I'm aware. Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. And if you're traveling for the holidays, if you're going on a plane or going on a road trip or whatever, having snacks like this are really handy that are plant-based. So you're not in a pickle when you get hungry and also like festive.
And you can still be seasonal and festive, enjoying the holidays while you're traveling.
And it's much cheaper to get your snacks at the grocery store and bring them with you than trying to get the same snacks at the airport for 2 to 3 to 4 times as much. So,
ding! Money saving tip.
So this, I think, what was this? $1.50 at the store, whereas I think at the airport this is probably like $3.
Yeah.
So yeah, at least
50% less at the store.
And yeah. I know that for me, before I started traveling a lot, I had not traveled a lot. So I'd only go on like every couple of years, I'd go on a vacation. And I didn't know that you could bring your own snacks.
Yeah.
And so I would just wait until either I made it to my destination or I would buy the snacks because I didn't know that TSA would allow you to bring your own food. So you can bring your own food if it's not a liquid in case you are traveling for the holidays and you're not used to traveling.
Yeah, that's a really good tip.
And especially when you're trying to be trying to follow a plant-based diet, you want to make sure you've always got some good snacks or lunch or something you bring it with you so you don't get caught out.
And especially if you're hangry like me, like I'm the worst, grumpiest person when I'm hungry, so I need to carry this with me everywhere.
Yep. We're familiar.
She knows how cranky I am.
I know, but also everyone gets hangry, and I have Foodies. Snacks with me all the time, so good pick.
Yep.
All right.
I got these little coins. They're called gelt, and we're going to have our nephews over for Hanukkah one night this year, and
I thought we were going to try them now. No?
No. I guess I could, yeah.
No.
I'll try. Let's eat some chocolate.
Can you really go wrong with chocolate? But actually, vegan gelt can be a little bit difficult to find.
Yeah, I've looked for it, and I was really surprised. This is 70%.
We can share.
This is deliciously rich 70% dark chocolate.
So the brand is Divine.
It says also that it contains fair milk, trade. That it may contain milk, and it does not. And that is often put there on vegan on chocolates that happen to be vegan because they were processed in a facility that may have allergens.
It's just like a legal disclaimer. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but the other thing is, so a lot of gelt, it's like a kid's game that you play with dreidels and you really win yummy. The gelt. And so a lot of times it's milk chocolate, and that's why it can be a little bit harder to find.
Delicious. That's delicious.
These are yummy. Yay.
All right.
Those sprouts.
So many good things available at this time of the year.
Will you sing the dreidel song first?
Dreidel, dreidel, dreidel. I made it out of play. When it's dry and ready.
Get it dry and ready.
A dreidel, I shall play. All right. So I just showed going through. If you want to not have to do work around Thanksgiving, you can also get pre-made gravy that is vegan. Gravy is actually really easy to make.
So easy and so cheap.
Yep, and so inexpensive. So if you are not lazy like me, you can make your own. But it's nice to have this in a pickle. It is from the brand Tofurky, and they had this at Sprouts. Yeah, and you just heat it up on the stove and it's ready to go.
Yeah, drizzle it on the your roast and
have you guys
it's gonna
had
be
this
delicious.
One?
I haven't tried this brand, no.
Okay. Yeah.
We had it in a video that Michelle will link.
Yeah, we taste tested all the vegan turkeys. Was that one? No, we made it.
We have a vegan Thanksgiving how to do it easy style.
Yes, I'll link our whole guide to Thanksgiving. It's just worldvegan.com/Thanksgiving that links to all of the videos that we filmed.
Also a cool thing that we haven't talked about in a while because Michelle and I haven't done videos in forever, but we wrote a cookbook and it's coming out in October 2020, so kind of a long time, but there will be like a whole vegan Thanksgiving, so stay tuned for that. Our gravy recipe is so good.
It's so good. Mushrooms, but but they're like mushrooms
chopped finely,
but I love this gravy. Like it's so delicious.
So even for someone that doesn't like mushrooms, you love
people
this
who don't like
of you.
Yep.
Wow. Okay. Amazing. All right, so mine isn't...
You can show multiple if you want to.
Oh, no, it's good.
Okay.
So mine isn't a plant-based swap, but it's one of my favorite things at Thanksgiving, which is to make my own cranberry sauce. So, yeah, back in Australia, we don't have fresh cranberries like this. So since I've been in the US, I've just been obsessed with fresh cranberries. So I love to just grab bags and bags of cranberries at this time of the year, and I just make cranberry sauce. I put cranberries in muffins. I just use cranberries for everything at the moment. And also, I like to mix the cranberries with persimmon. So by adding some persimmon to the cranberries, I'm able to use a little bit less sugar. Mm-hmm. So, because normally with cranberry sauce, you'll add a lot of sugar to sort of even out the tartness of the cranberries. So I like to add some persimmon. So they're in season at the moment too.
And is the cranberry sauce on your website?
It is on my
Rachel
website.
Is an amazing cook and food photographer.
Didn't you
and
just
blogger.
Put up a photo that was like all my favorite cranberry recipes?
We will link that below.
I did.
Also, I've recently had turkeys that have been visiting my yard.
Oh, really?
Like wild turkeys in the neighborhood.
Hey guys,
I had to take a moment and show you what's happening behind the scenes filming. This is my front door. And all of these turkeys just came up. They're like wild neighborhood turkeys that just roam around. And they're just chilling in my front yard. Hello, guys. Oh my gosh, I love it. I love this one in particular. Hi. Hey there. Oh, and a squirrel. This one's sunbathing back there. Oh my gosh, too cute. And from Farm Sanctuary, I learned that they love just munching on cranberries. Mm-hmm. Really? So I feel like sprinkling them in my yard so like the squirrels and the turkeys can eat some. Awesome.
Making your own cranberry sauce is really, really easy. About 10 minutes, 15 minutes, and you've got your cranberry sauce ready. Awesome. Recipes on my blog.
I will be making that for Thanksgiving. I've made it before, but I've never made I don't have my ultimate favorite. Yet.
Yeah. So and I'll be just grab yours. A couple of Tony's persimmons. She's got bowls and bowls of them at the moment.
My neighbor is so generous and he's been bringing over boxes.
The mother load.
Every week. He said he's picking about 100 a week and then he's bringing us a quarter of
his persimmon tree is enormous.
I know. He has so 30 fruit trees. 30.
In his backyard, mostly?
In his backyard and his front yard.
That's amazing.
You picked the right place to live.
Okay, so this is a little bit old school. New packaging, but old school flavor. Woo. And it is the Silk Nog. I love it. I love the regular soy-based Silk Nog. They have an almond, I think, and a
coconut.
I don't want that.
No,
get it out of here. I want Silk Soy Milk Nog. And it's fun if you're having a holiday party to serve it. I do not spike mine, as many of you know. I do not drink, but I do.
My hubby will be spiking his.
Yeah, in our cookbook, we actually have a nog, and everyone was like, "This would be great with bourbon or whatever you put in it." And I was like, "No, don't mess in my recipe."
Yeah. Yeah, it's an exciting time though. Even at Sprouts, they had at least three different types of nogs there, and every brand it seems that makes a nut milk is now coming out with holiday nogs, and then peppermint, cocos and peppermint mochas.
I also got this. It looks very similar, but it's like pumpkin spice, and that was pretty good too.
Yes.
Yummy. Yeah.
If you guys
have
tried these, let us know down below what your favorite brand is. We should do a taste test of nogs.
That'd be fun. And I think does Trader Joe's have its own
I think they rebranded.
Rebrand. Okay.
Yeah, I think I saw some the other day. Yeah.
Awesome. All right. Oh. So I'm taking
Michelle actually has a video she could link to of Trader Joe finds of pumpkin themed.
Yes.
So
pumpkin
themed. She'll include that.
All right, all about convenient Thanksgiving planning. This is stuffing, and Sprouts actually has two different types of vegan stuffing. They have this one, which is accidentally vegan, and then they also have this boudin sourdough stuffing, which is a little bit more expensive, but most of the ingredients are organic, and there is no dairy or eggs in them anywhere. So totally can be made vegan. I love that it's from Boudin's. It's a little bit higher quality. Its ingredients are mostly organic. And I'm just excited to try. Oh, yeah. Organic. Najimu. All the cool things. And I'm excited to try a different one this year that's really easy. It's basically pre-made for you. You don't have to dry your own bread. But it's scaled a little classier. So we will see how it goes.
Delicious. We've got herbs in there and things.
Yeah. Herbs and things. Yeah. And I think you just add, what do? You add...
usually
vegetable broth instead of chicken broth, and then there's usually butter, right? And then you just add plant-based. Oh, this one calls for olive oil.
Perfect.
So, and then other things like lemon juice and celery and onions and stuff like that. So you can totally easily veganize making this, and I can't wait to give it a try.
Yummy. Also, I just noticed how weird I was being. There's a mosquito flying around, so I was just scratching myself, and then I was trying to blow it away from me. And so if you see me over here being
we spent
that's me trying to blow away the mosquito.
We spent 5 minutes at the vegan burger shop today looking at this little bug that we could swear was a miniature hummingbird. It was a little insect flying around.
The size of a mosquito.
He was blue.
But it blew.
Yeah. And he looked like he had the shape of a bird. If you guys know what insect that is, help us out. Cause it was
cool. I need to Google that because that was the most adorable little thing I've ever seen.
Is there an app, identify this insect?
There should be. Yeah. Okay.
All right. So my next one is apple cider. So this is another one. I mean, you can get any brand of apple cider that you like. Everyone's selling it at the moment. So you can drink it just like this, but I actually love it. And I think most people at this time of the year like to heat it up a little, have it hot. So I'll put this, I'll just pour a little bit in a mug and then I'll just zap it in the microwave for a minute or so just to heat it up. Then I'm gonna just add a second item to mine now. So if you wanna get spicy, you can add these mulling spices. So, I mean, all the packaging will be, instructions will be different depending on what brand you buy, but you just basically add some of the spices to the apple cider and mix it all together, and it is just the most beautiful drink to have in the during the holidays, Thanksgiving, Christmas, anytime really. It's just so warming and comforting.
Like the smell when you go over to someone's house, or if you're having guests over, if you just put these on the stove and kind of leave it on a very low heat, so it's just wafting up smells, even if you weren't gonna drink it, is so good.
Yeah, and you just. It's cute to serve your guests with a cinnamon stick.
Yeah.
Right.
Or so, you can dump, if you don't have mulling spices, you could stick cinnamon sticks in there.
Right. So this, so the mulling spices that comes with this packaging here is cinnamon, orange peel, allspice, cloves, and ginger.
Yeah, so you can easily make your own if you
If you don't have the stuff, just make it yourself, or just put a cinnamon stick in there, a couple of cloves, whatever you like.
It's
really, really delicious. So I'm a non-drinker as well, so this is my go-to holiday drink when I feel like something warming. But I know a lot of people also like to make a mulled wine at this time of the year as well. So you can get some red wine and then you can add the mulling spices to that as well. It's a very similar method of heating the wine or heating the apple cider and adding this.
You know what I was just thinking would be a really cute like little house or little gift or maybe attachment to gifts is making your own mulling spices and putting them in like a little sack with like a little
really
note
cute.
On it would be super cute.
Yeah, that'd be really
I should
cute.
Make that for Colleen when she's zero
so
waste.
Good.
Oh yeah.
Last year for Christmas we went to Apple Hill. And got like mixed
in Sacramento, like you can go apple picking and
yes,
stuff.
Yes. Yeah. And we went and got there was like a mixed nuts or tea or some mixed thing in bulk. And then I tore up a paper bag and I wrapped it in there and then I wrote directly on the tore up paper bag. No, her address and mailed it to her so
she
that she wouldn't
that.
Get any so she wouldn't
Next
get any
level.
Zero waste.
That's so awesome. That it was a zero waste gift.
Yeah.
That would be
that's
something
good.
Fun to give her.
Yeah, you could do that.
Totally,
yeah, for
making
sure.
Your own.
Easy to make your own.
Awesome.
So that, that's one of my favorites.
Yeah. Yum. I love it. We should have that tonight.
I think that's it.
I think
wait,
we're gonna
I have one more.
I have one more too, but I didn't know if I
Yeah, do it.
Okay. So these are peppermint sandwich creams. They're kind of like peppermint Oreos, which do exist and are also vegan. But I
Sprouts version.
Got the Sprouts version. And I think that if you don't like baking and you're having a holiday party or you're having guests over for dinner during the holiday season, it's an easy way to have a tray of desserts out without having to put in all the effort of baking.
Yeah, you can also do fun things like crush them up and put them on top of cupcakes, or we are gonna have a vegan ice cream cake recipe in our cookbook that comes from Jolene, and she uses, or like you can use Oreos like to line the insides of the cake. It's really, really good.
Oh my God.
Jolene's my mother-in-law, by the way.
Hi, Jolene. okay, one more, only because I saw this and I've never tried this before, and this is a popular thing at Thanksgiving, is having whipped cream on top of your pumpkin pie or your ice cream or whatever you're eating. And now Ready Whip Vegan is so popular that
so
they came
easy,
out with
yeah.
a non-dairy coconut whip. Should we try it, guys?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So this is the Ready Whip. They also have other brands. Trader Joe's now has a coconut whipped cream that comes in a can, and So Delicious has like frozen ones that are like, what's that called? Cocoa whip. But Cool whip. Okay,
every time I go to the store, there's just more and more plant-based versions of
it
items
works
on
so
these.
I was actually.
Okay, my turn.
It's so satisfying.
Whoa. That's delicious.
That's so good.
What is that? Coconut.
Yes. Good job, Ready Whip. Also, on holiday drinks, peppermint mochas, anything that you're making that's warm, cocoa-y,
coffee.
I love
that it whips, like, in the
swirl. It looks beautiful.
Yeah, it's
and it'll
so fun.
Make people who are coming to your house who are questioning the vegan thing, like, not think twice because it looks exactly like standard what they're used
and
to.
And it's a brand that they're familiar with.
Familiar with, yeah.
So, good job. Ready Whip. And clearly labeled vegan, very handy. And that is it for our little Thanksgiving haul. I hope you guys found this helpful. As we've mentioned, we have tons of Thanksgiving resources. Rachel has a bazillion recipes on her blog, so we will link those below. I've got a whole Thanksgiving guide and resource with all of our past videos that we filmed over at worldofvegan.com/Thanksgiving. Tony had a Thanksgiving ebook, but is that still available?
Mm-mm.
No. Okay, so you can find more budget-friendly and really easy accessible recipes over on plantbasedonabudget.com. What else?
Just say happy Thanksgiving,
happy
everyone.
Thanksgiving.
Yeah. Also, one more thing is that Michelle and I have done several Surviving the Holidays podcast episodes where we talk at length about how to survive. And we have some good content coming out this year about how to answer tough questions. So stay tuned for those. And Michelle will link what we currently have in this post.
Yep. And you can find the podcast at anywhere you listen to podcasts, on iTunes, wherever. It's the Plant Powered People Podcast.
Mm-hmm.
So thank you guys so much for tuning in. Have a beautiful Thanksgiving and we will see you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Thanksgiving.
Mwah.
Watch.
Okay, guys, I had to take a moment and show you what's happening behind the scenes filming. This is my front door and all of these turkeys just came up. They're like wild neighborhood turkeys that just roam around. And they're just chilling in my front yard. Hello, guys. Oh my gosh, I love it. I love this one in particular. Hi. Hey there. Oh, and a squirrel. This one's sunbathing back there. Oh my gosh, too cute.